Now I'm joined with THV11's Laura Monteverdi, who's been following some of the protests. There have been supporters of the bill, people against the bill today. What did you find out there?
That's right, Kevin. For days, protesters and supporters of House Bill 1228 have lined the steps of the Capitol, making sure their voices are heard. And that all came down to today when that final decision was made.
We are Arkansas! We are Arkansas!
An intense scene outside the Capitol Thursday morning as protesters line the steps, waiting for a decision to come from inside.
I'm kind of trying to be optimistic that things will turn out for the best and that we still have a chance even until the last minute.
I'm consciously optimistic that we'll make progress, but I'm not entirely sure what kind of progress it will be.
Though the governor decided not to sign HB 1228 as is on Wednesday, supporters stayed optimistic that the amended Senate bill would pass the House.
It's not the same law that we started out with, but this law has almost everything in it that we had hoped to see in the final product, and that's what counts.
And when it did, the reaction inside the Capitol was far different than the atmosphere outside earlier in the day.
A little uncomfortable, but I'm hoping that this is a good start.
It's been a long road, but I tell you what, it's worth it.
And even though opponents of the original bill were happy to see some changes, they say the fight is not over.
Until there are protections for LGBTQ identified people, as well as anybody who could be harmfully affected by these bills, it won't be over.
Some of the protesters I spoke with say they're not as familiar with Senate Bill 975 as they are with House Bill 1228, so they'll have to read up a little bit on that. They also say they're surprised with how fast the governor took action to sign the bill. For now, I'll send it back to you guys in the studio.